It is estimated that 300 million people worldwide have asthma. At least 52 New Zealanders, or one person every week, dies from asthma. Asthma is the most common cause of children hospital admissions.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I'm 23 years old. I'm studying Diploma in Ministry at Vision College in Hamilton. I work with kids with disabilities and I absolutely love it. So I have chronic severe asthma. I was first diagnosed with asthma when I was 3 years old and I've had it ever since. Growing up, I knew that asthma wasn't common for everyone. I was in and out of hospital and wasn't able to run around the field like most kids were. I just couldn't do lots of things that normal kids could do. So going in and out of hospital, I was missing some events and some opportunities. At times I was annoyed that I couldn't run around with everybody else. I remember one time I was in hospital, a friend of mine was playing at a concert and I was determined to go and watch her play, but the doctors were like, no, you can't go. So I just kind of walked out of the hospital just so I could see her, and I came back that night. It's quite scary going into hospital because you have all these machines going and you're struggling to breathe as well. Like, it's kind of a freaky experience. You have these machines testing all these things, and hospital's not a place where you should be. A few years ago, my asthma was probably the worst it's probably ever been. So I could barely walk 1K without getting breathless. I couldn't participate in doing children's songs that I used to love to do at Sunday school with the kids. I couldn't even jump on the trampoline with lots of kids at work. So it was quite a struggle to do normal day-to-day things in life. So this was really emotionally draining on me as well, because I should be able to do what normal teenagers should be able to do. I was referred to U-Kenetics, a special gym for people with diabetes, asthma and heart conditions. So this changed my life completely. So when I first got to the gym, I could barely walk 1K without getting breathless. I was on the bike, 3 minutes on, 3 minutes, 3 minutes on, 1 minute off, at the lowest wattage you could get. When I left that gym at the end of last year, I could bike 20 minutes non-stop at 65 watts, and that was a walk in the park. I could walk on the treadmill for ages. I could do a whole lot of stuff that I couldn't do 2 years ago. I could now jump on the trampoline with my kids at work. I could now participate in all the songs at Sunday school without getting breathless, and I could walk more than 1K without getting breathless, and now today I can walk for ages without getting breathless, and I'm going to do a half marathon to prove that. So since I've left U-Kenetics and moved to Hamilton, I have joined the gym, and I go to the gym 3 to 4 times a week, and so I had to do a program that they wrote for me at the end of last year, and I am, while training for this half marathon, I also go for a long walk in the weekend. The aim is to complete the half marathon in under 4.5 hours. So I've got a support crew coming to maybe do the half marathon with me, or just to even support me at the marathon, cheering me on and stuff. Looking back, it's about looking how far I have come. It's not comparing myself to others, because I could get so disheartened about, oh my gosh, this person's running on the treadmill. But I need to actually look at myself and be like, hey, I can actually walk more than 1K. This is a big deal for me. And focus on how far you have come. Don't focus so much on where you need to go. Focus on how far you have come. And don't be afraid to reach out for help and to be honest. I think one of the main things for me is I have to be honest with myself and with others about my asthma. So many times I've been like, oh no, I'm fine. Where I know for a fact that I've needed to be in hospital, but I've just been too stubborn to be like, no, actually, I need to be in hospital. And I've come to realise that I do need to be honest, because it's a life and death situation. This year is the Asthma Foundation's 50th year anniversary, and I need your help to help raise more money for the Asthma Foundation. so they can continue to do the work that they are doing with asthma in New Zealand and finding new ways of helping to prevent asthma. Go to givealittle.co.nz walk for asthma and donate as much as you can. Every little bit helps. You can like me on Facebook. There I will be posting updates on how I'm going, my progress, and then on the day, how I did, and check me out on Facebook, walk for asthma. I'm beating the odds of asthma, because a couple of years ago, my specialist was like, you can't walk a half marathon, that's an unrealistic goal, and now I'm going to be achieving this goal at the end of the year. And if I can do it, anybody can.